Hi everybody, thank you for watching my video on physics. Today, our discussion is on an experiment to find the heat capacity of an object. We shall use a box of lemon tea as an example. The apparatus used in this experiment includes a power supply, a geometer, an immersion heater, a stirrer, a polystyrene cup, also called a foam cup with a lid, a thermometer, a pair of scissors, and of course, a pack of lemon tea. First of all, use the pair of scissors to cut a hole from the box of lemon tea. Pour the lemon tea into the foam cup. Insert the thermometer, the stirrer, and the immersion heater into the cup. Connect the heater to the geometer and the geometer to the power supply. Record the initial geometer reading, which is 89,800 joule, and the initial temperature of the lemon tea, which is 19 degrees Celsius. Turn on the power supply. Stir the lemon tea continuously. After a while, turn off the power supply. Record the final geometer reading, which is 98,300 joule. Since the heater is still hot, the temperature of the lemon tea keeps rising even though the power supply is turned off. We have to wait until the maximum temperature of the lemon tea is reached. The maximum temperature recorded is 26 degrees Celsius. From the data, the energy transferred is 98,300 minus 89,800, which is 8,500 joule. The change in temperature is 26 degrees Celsius minus 19 degrees Celsius, which is 7 degrees Celsius. By definition, heat capacity is equal to the energy transfer Q divided by the change in temperature delta T. The heat capacity is then calculated by dividing 8,500 by 7. Hence, the result is 1014 joule per degree Celsius. Now, if the experiment is repeated, we may not get exactly the same result. There are several reasons. Firstly, the amount of lemon tea used may not be the same. Secondly, the constituents of the lemon tea may vary from one pad to the other. Finally, there are experimental errors which cannot be avoided, such as heat loss to the surrounding, and the energy needed to heat up the apparatus, such as the heater, the thermometer, and the stirrer. In summary, this video demonstrates how the heat capacity of an object is measured. By knowing the energy transfer and the change in temperature, heat capacity can be calculated. I hope this video can help you understand more about how the heat capacity of an object can be measured. Thank you for watching.